Yes, I think the market was somewhat concerned in the last few days on the spike in interbank rates and whether or not that was signalling a tightening of monetary policy. That obviously got people a bit concerned in terms of the growth trajectory for China, and this much stronger than expected PMI number, I think, has gone some way to alleviating those concerns. Within the detail, the number was good across the board. The only weak spot was employment. And I guess now we're going to start looking very closely at the revision, or the actual, as it were, which will be in a few weeks' time. And we will get a better sense of whether this uptick that we're seeing is going to be carried through into the official PMI as well. Well, I'd like to see the final reading first. If you remember, last month we had a positive preliminary flash, and then that was cruelly taken away from us when the final reading came in. So I think the market's just a little bit cautious. That's just why equities haven't really moved substantially today or this morning. The detail was positive. It was encouraging. All the sub-indices showed improvement except employment. And so I guess that we will now start focusing on whether or not China is able to sustain the pace of its GDP upswing in the second quarter into the third. Well, it may sound counterintuitive raising rates in this sort of slowing growth environment, but such is the inflationary pressure in India, and frankly pressure on the currency as well, that it's probably the right decision to tighten monetary policy, albeit ahead of elections, such that these inflationary pressures can be managed and dealt with. It'll only be a small hike, it'll be around 25 basis points, but I think the message that the new central governor is trying to communicate is one of prudence in the face of price pressures. Well, there's a couple of factors that we're looking at. First of all, the ability of Asian economies to leverage the upswing in global demand, particularly in developed markets. We want to see whether or not export growth can actually accelerate, and whether low and accommodative monetary policy is supportive of that. To be fair, we've not seen a huge upswing in export growth yet. It seems that there's a bit of a delay between the growth story in developed markets and that translating and feeding through to Asia. It's not yet happened. It's more a case of North Asia, certainly, than South and Southeast Asia. But if we're looking at retail sales, for example, in Korea, or if we're looking at industrial production and manufacturing, there are positive signs. But we haven't really seen that firmly and fully translated to an uptick in exports.